Father Stefan Starzynski is very familiar with the end-of-life decisions families need to make. He's been working as a chaplain at Inova Fairfax Hospital in the Diocese of Arlington, Virginia, for 8 years. Thank you so much for joining us today. We just saw in Alan's piece that many families are calling the Bioethics Center in the last days and hours of a loved one's life. How soon should families have these discussions about the end of life?
Actually, they should have the discussions personally. The person in the hospital should definitely have these discussions when they're conscious, when they're able to discuss it rationally, because what happens so often is you have a DNR wondering if the person wants to be resuscitated, and they're in the hospital bed, and they've never had this conversation. The hospital wants to do what the patient wants as the first line, and that's certainly something that should be clearly said when they're conscious.
Now, Father Stefan...
It should be before they come to the hospital.
Absolutely. Father Stefan, you are on the ground. You are on the front lines of this. The hospital is caring for the medical needs of the patient, but you are caring for the whole person and the spiritual needs there. What are you seeing? Just this morning, I know that you were running off to care for someone and give them last rites.
Well, to show you what the life of a chaplain is like, I sent out a little page on my Facebook. Pray that the pager doesn't go off from 8:45 to 9:15. And I was getting ready for the interview, but then it literally 5 minutes before going on to get a page that a person needed last rites. And that's the whole purpose. Giving last rites is more important than being on TV and doing all this, because what's the value of a soul? And I went there and I put a scapular on the man. I did the last rites, apostolic blessing, litany of saints, and chapel of divine mercy. And beautifully enough, the family had never even heard of the chapel of divine mercy. And I recited the line, if you pray the chapel in the presence of those who are dying, I'll come not as the just judge, but as the merciful savior. So the first chaplet they ever heard might be the first chaplet of the chapel that accompanies this man into eternal glory.
That's beautiful. And you started a ministry that specifically teaches the value of redemptive suffering. What does that mean?
Suffering has value. You know, Padre Pio said prayer connected to suffering. Fulton Sheen said the greatest tragedy is wasted suffering. The greatest tragedy is wasted suffering. So it's actually kind of a retelling of the story of St. Lawrence, where St. Lawrence was a martyr and the Emperor Diocletian, I believe, said, bring all the valuables of the church. And he brought the sick and the suffering into the church. And that's why St. Lawrence was killed. But the sick, our suffering has value. And so I'm trying to have the patients understand in the hospital, or all people that suffer, that you are not forgotten. You are a vital member of the body of Christ in uniting your sufferings with your prayer. So when I go into rooms, I often will say to people, pray for me and my intentions.
They're in a moment where their prayers are of utmost power. Having conversations about death is so difficult, and we often keep it from the public eye. Did the pandemic change the openness of patients to discuss faith and planning for death?
It did, because actually the pandemic brought in a whole new reality. It brought in a whole new reality of people dying without any family members being there. And so it actually brought the reality of death much closer to home.
What about what you see on the ground in terms of spiritual healing? Have there been moments where the doctors could do nothing, but you could really come in and heal someone?
Definitely. I used to think in my priesthood, like the greatest miracle would say be healing of cancer, healing of, diabetes. Now I'm realizing the greatest healing is the healing of peace, peace of soul. And that's why the most important thing for a person to do before they're about to go to God, or even before that, is to make their peace with God. And the chaplaincy is very important, because the doctors, God heals through medicine and he heals through the sacraments. There's one Lord who's healer. And so often when the doctors have done everything they possibly can, And they stand back and they see the necessity of the family praying, they see the necessity of the sacraments, and the family surrenders their loved one to God. So definitely, I always tell people, or I this is one of the things I say, if somebody's about to die, I say they've received all the sacraments of the church, they're surrounded by the people who love them and they love, be at peace and let them go to God.
That's beautiful. Well, we hope that we all can find that peace, and we're grateful for your ministry, Father.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.